You're watching a Dick Van Dyke Show box set on TV Land. Stay tuned.
Boy, the way Glenn Miller played. Guys like us, we had it made. Those were the days.
And you knew where you were then.
Girls were girls and men were men. Mister, we could use a man like Herbert Hoover again. Didn't need no welfare state.
Everybody pulled his weight.
G.I. Roll was sour and great. Those were the days.
Here's the story of a lovely lady who was swinging at three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold. The youngest one in curls. It's the story of a man named Brady, who was busy with three boys of his own. They were four men living all together, yet they were all alone. The Brady Bunch, the Brady Bunch. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch.
From this tropic port, aboard this tiny ship. The ship's a crowd on the shore of this uncharted desert isle, with Gilligan, the skipper too, a billionaire and his wife, the movie star, the professor and Mary Ann, here on Gilligan's Isle.
So you think that you've got troubles? Well, trouble's a bubble. So tell old Mr. Trouble to get lost, hold your head up high and stop crying, start crying. And don't forget to keep your fingers crossed. Ooh, when you find the joy of living is loving and giving, you'll be there when the winning dice are tossed. A tossed, a smile is just a frown that's turned upside down. So smile on that frown, defrost, defrost. And don't forget to keep your fingers crossed. Ba-dum-bum. Yeah!
Hello world, it's a song that we're singing. Come on, get happy. A whole lot of loving is what we'll be bringing. We'll make you happy. See, we had a dream, we go traveling together.
Spread a little love and then we keep moving on.
Something always happens whenever we're together.
We get a happy feeling when we're singing a song.
Traveling along, there's a song that we're singing.
Come on, get happy.
A whole lot of loving is what we'll be bringing.
We'll make you happy.
Come on,
we'll make you happy. Make you happy.
Incorporated.
Gonna do it. Give us energy.
But it's time you started living. It's time you let someone else do some good.
Love is all around, no need to waste it. You can use it now, why don't you take it? You might just make it after all. You might just make it after all.
Beans don't burn on the grill. Took a whole lot of trying just to get up that hill. Now we're up in the bigger league. I guess I'll turn that back. As long as we live, you and me, baby, ain't nothing wrong with that. No, we're gonna go to the east side, to a deluxe apartment.
The Hollywood Palladium. Let's go to the TV Land Awards. Exciting stars, awards, tributes, and performances. Exclusive backstage footage. You are about to have an intimate look at these and other well-known stars and their alluring world called Hollywood. A glittering lineup of stars and the glamour in which they live. A magical kingdom whose personalities are the royalty of entertainment. The fascinating world of Hollywood and its people, all in color. Live from Sunset Boulevard in the heart of Hollywood, get ready for the event of a lifetime. It's the first annual TV Land Awards. Featuring Paula Abdul, Don Adams, the cast of American Dream, Bea Arthur, Kathy Bates, Halle Berry, Barbara Billingsley, Diahann Carroll, David Cassidy, Ray Charles, Dick Clark, Ted Danson, James Stewart, Janae Dubois, Barbara E. Barbara Felder, Gilligan's Island Singers, Bill Cole, Stan Farber, Ian Freeburn Smith, and Gene Marlino. Don Gray, Cindy Greco, Davy Jones, Shirley Jones, Gabe Kaplan, Bernie Capel, Don Knox, Cheryl Ladd, Barry Livingston, Stanley Livingston, Gavin McLeod, Lee Major, Mama, Rosemary, Penny Marshall, Larry Matthew, Maureen McCauley, Reba McIntyre, Harry Tyler Moore, Nichelle Nichols, Leonard Nemo, Matthew Perry, Stephanie Power, Carl Reiner, Rob Reiner, Doris Roberts, William Shatner, Mira Sorvino, Sally Struthers, Dick Van Dyke, The Fantastics, Barry Williams, Cindy Williams, and Henry Winkler with the TV Land Orchestra and Dancers. Welcome your host, John Ritter.
Woo! Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I asked for Eric Estrada. This is all they could come up with. Hello, everybody. Good evening. And welcome to TV Land. For those of you who just tuned in to this time every night, this is not Sanford and Son. Don't raise your threat level. Sanford and Son will return tomorrow in its regular time slot. But tonight, we thought we would try something completely different. A new show. Please do not be alarmed. Take your hand off the remote, unclench your trembling fingers, and relax. This won't be hard. First of all, excuse me, got my head up my again. Sorry. This is an award show, And you don't have to worry about the plot, and we are loaded up with stars because tonight we celebrate all that is best in the TV that was, is, and evermore shall be classic television. Most of our awards were chosen by you, the viewer at home, over the last few months by voting online at tvland.com. And I'm sorry, but to the guys in the booth, I would like to take this opportunity to say a special hello to everyone in my chat room who stopped what they were doing long enough to vote. You know who you are just as long as the authorities don't. But back to classic TV, right? That's right. Our viewers have chosen their favorites in a number of brand new categories that we call Viewer's Choice Awards. And the experts at TV Land have decided to launch the first annual TV Land Awards with a group of special awards to programs and personalities who have made an indelible impact on the American cultural landscape. Don't worry, none of them is Meet the Press. They are all the kinds of shows that you have grown to love on TV Land, especially if you aren't old enough to have loved them the first time around. So to start us off is a great friend of mine who is himself a TV classic. He's an actor, director, producer, philanthropist, lecturer, educator, photocopier, computer technician, role and life model, the lovely Mr. Henry Winkler. Look at TV Land. Is this really TV Land, Henry?
This is great. This
it's
is
so
great.
Wonderful that you are here to start us off.
Well, you know what? What is this?
Did you get that?
I got this.
Backstage.
They did. They handed this to me.
Oh, you know what this is, Henry?
I don't know
what
it is.
On award shows, usually they're an envelope.
Yes.
Well, because this is TV Land, this is what you get to open. We're using this instead of an envelope. You just peel back the edge, don't you know? Don't look at that.
The winner is where the fried chicken used to be.
Yeah, right. Well, you got the fried chicken. Did you? That's good because the beef Wellington is really foul.
I told them I would not present beef Wellington.
No, it's no good.
It was fried chicken or nothing.
That's the way. Buddy, you better not open it now. You've got categories to describe
and
nominees to announce.
Okay.
You're a very busy man.
You look very handsome.
You do this. Oh, you smooth-talking devil.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. Thank you very much. We all love you here, Henry.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, John.
Wow. Hi, Doris. It is so nice to see everybody. And I watch you. So you know what? First, I would like to say this is the very first TV Land Viewer's Choice Award, and it's for Working Stiff. This particular case, it refers to your favorite classic All-American Joe or Jane, who has to make a living running a bus, driving a cab, running a diner, an assembly line, and getting laughs while doing it. So here are your choices.
Working Stiff of the Year. Ralph Cramden, The Honeymooners.
How about that? How could they do that to me? Me, who has worked and drove a bus for that company for 15 years. 15 years driving a bus. Aggravation, 101 aggravations every day. Driving a bus in the summertime, dying from the heat. In the wintertime, freezing from the cold. All kinds of weather. Through the rain, the snow, and the sleet. You know that sign they have in the post office? The mail gets through no matter what kind of weather. You know why? Because the mailman rides with me. That's
Laverne DeFazio and Shirley Feeney. Laverne and Shirley.
Well, I was grabbing the bottles. I cut my hands up. I guess I was sort of responsible.
Responsible? You certainly were. You were responsible for helping the company. That's what you were. You're a hero, Laverne. I'd be proud to shake your hand.
Roseanne Connor. Roseanne.
Fine, Jackie. Try my life, okay? Go work over the bike shop for no money and then have to come here to this dump and work for Preppy the Clown here. Oh, yeah. Oh, that reminds me. Leon, I need to get Friday off, okay?
Well, gee, I don't know, Roseanne. I mean, where am I going to find somebody to stand in the middle of my restaurant and do nothing on such short notice?
See what I have to put up with?
Alex Rieger. Taxi.
No, we're all part-time here. I'm part-time. I only work 60 hours a week. You see that guy over there? Now, he's an actor. The guy on the phone, he's a prize fighter. This lady over here, she's a beautician. Man behind her, he's a writer. Me, I'm a cab driver. I'm the only cab driver in this place.
Okay, all right. Very exciting. And the winner is... Oh, the winner. The winners have actually never been duplicated. Ladies and gentlemen, Penny Marshall and Cindy Williams as Laverne and Shirley.
But we're very old.
Yes.
I'm keeping the TV dinner.
Well, you have to split that with me. First of all, we want to say what an honor it is to have been nominated in such great company with Taxi, The Honeymooners, and Roseanne.
Yes, it's embarrassing because Jackie Gleason was great, Roseanne's great, and so is Judd Hirsch.
Yes, and we want to say thank you to the creators of our show, Gary Marshall.
My brother.
Lowell Ganz.
My brother.
And Mark Rothman.
My brother.
Thank you to a marvelous cast, David Lander, Michael McKeon, Betty Garrett, Phil Foster,
Eddie Mecca.
And
Leslie Easterbrook,
Ed Marinaro.
Ed Marinaro.
Yes, and thank you to everyone who voted for us.
Yes, thanks to the viewers, because they're the only people who like us.
Thank you very much. And we'd like to accept these. We would like to accept these for everyone who has ever worked for minimum wage. Thank you.
Yes.
Tonight's TV Land Awards presented by Chevy Trucks. Up next on the first annual TV Land Awards, Kathy Bates with a special tribute to one of your all-time favorite comedies. And later, Halle Berry.
I heard it when he got that.
Sorry about the dust.
Come on, guys, let's go.
The powerful new Chevy Trailblazer EXT. Room for seven. Room for everything.
I left the bagels in the jet.
Chevy Trailblazer, like a rock.
You think it's easy being a bartender on a cruise ship? Try getting this all day.
Do you think that Brad likes me? You know, from cabin 112?
How did you get in here?
No, I'm sorry, Jimmy. J.J. Walker is not on my passenger list.
Julie, dear, when do we reach Cabo San Lucas?
Again, the name is Laura, and we're going to Bermuda.
There's no place like TV Land.
Hey! No!
And you're smart and you work so hard.
Billy, would you like me to call your mom and see if he can stay for dinner?
If you insist.
Introducing the Cinemeal Deal. Any large Pizza Hut pizza, America's favorite, with up to three toppings, just $11.99. Plus a generous order of our new freshly baked cinnamon sticks absolutely free. The $11.99 Cinemeal Deal. Spoil your family, not your budget.
You're powerful, smart.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
At Pizza Hut.
Nothing takes the fun out of a day home sick like a sore, runny nose. Thank goodness for Kleenex tissues. Kleenex lotion tissue is soothing to your sore nose so you can fully enjoy your day of misery.
These are the final days of the great shopping spree at JCPenney. Hurry in for 30% savings store-wide, plus extra savings on sale prices and clearance items. It's every girl's idea of fun.
It's all inside.
JCPenney.
Cancer.
The doctor walked into the room and said, "You have cancer, and it's inoperable. You have only 6 months to live." So I turned to my wife and said, 33 years together is not enough. So I decided to fight, and I started looking for options. Our daughter, who is a nurse, told me about Cancer Treatment Centers of America. It's like no hospital you've ever seen. They treated me, the whole person, not just my tumor, with the latest medical technology, nutrition, and supplements to stimulate my immune system to fight my cancer.
To find out about alternative treatment options at our hospitals, call toll-free 1-800-804-0755.
It's been 7 years now. I beat cancer, and so can you.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America, winning the fight against cancer every day.
Please welcome the Academy Award-nominated actress from About Schmidt, Kathy Bates.
Good evening. We'll be having a lot of fun tonight with classic TV, and that's because so much of what we remember from TV's first five decades is funny. Occasionally, one of those funny shows made such an impact on the medium, and in fact on American culture, that the people at TV Land feel the need to recognize it with an award. The show, of course, was hilarious, but it covered such side-splitting topics as racism, bigotry, feminism, ageism, homophobia, and rape. It had something profound to say about each of them, along with the laughs. It had fun with words, introducing a few choice ones that had never been heard on television before, and popularizing a few of the tamer variety, words like meathead and dingbat. It changed the face of the medium forever, spawning not only a handful of spin-off shows, but an entirely new adult way of looking at TV comedy and our country itself. Innovative is one way of describing it, which is why the award I'm about to present to All in the Family is called The Innovator. And here are some more reasons why.
In my day, nobody went around calling themselves Chicanos, Mexican-Americans, Afro-Americans. We was all Americans. After that, if a guy was a jig or a spick, it was his own business. The way Glenn Miller played.
Songs that made the hit parade.
All in the Family was entirely different from anything we'd seen, much more honest than anything we'd seen.
Just because a guy is sensitive and he's an intellectual and he wears glasses, you make him out a queer.
I never said a guy who wears glasses is a queer. A guy who wears glasses is a four eyes. A guy who is a fag is a queer.
We had a commitment when we were doing these shows to make an audience howl or to make them fear or to make them cry.
I got a lump in my breast.
What did you just say?
I got a lump.
Oh,
in...
Mama.
That's the first time I said it out loud.
We're going to be funny. That was the purpose, to make people laugh. But beyond that, we're going to make them think a bit.
We can always adopt. Hey, that way we'd be giving our love to a kid that's already been born.
Well, maybe later. But first, it's important to me as a woman to try to have one of my own.
Honey.
Michael, don't you touch me unless you mean business.
Mike's relationship with Archie, I think, is probably the biggest part of the show. It's what keeps it moving forward. It's the point of friction.
Can I just say one thing to you, though?
If it don't take too long.
Why is it that you can never...
Hold up!
Carroll was utterly devoted to the character and the mission. He was so gifted as the writer of that character. None of us could write Archie Bunker the way it flew out of him.
If you're gonna have a change of life, you gotta do it right now. I'm gonna give you just 30 seconds. Now come on, change!
Anytime Archie did step over the line, Edith Bunker wasn't someone you wanted to hurt. She certainly wasn't someone you wanted angry at you. It hardly ever happened, but when it happened, you know, you felt it deeply.
No! I don't want to go to Florida. I don't want to go anywhere. And if you want to make a phone call, you make it yourself.
Laughter and tears are very close together. And using them both in drama was the greatest kick in the world. So we grabbed the opportunity with everything we did.
I know you always thought I hated you.
Oh, shh.
But I love you.
All the Family is a great show. You know, one of the things that gets lost in the discussion about how it was groundbreaking and how it was courageous, both of which it was incredibly funny.
Sweet home.
Ladies and gentlemen, from All in the Family, Rob Reiner and Sally Struthers.
Up, what would Archie and I be fighting about? I just thought as we were walking up, what would we be fighting about? I'd probably be saying something like, you know, this misguided, disastrous policy of the Bush administration of preemptive attacks on a sovereign nation is so ill thought of, and it would be a disaster for the world, and we're driving the rest of the world away from us, and we're going to exacerbate the terrorists and inflame the Arab world. And he would turn to me in his eloquent way and go, "You meet him." And then what would Gloria say?
Oh, boy.
Gloria would say something like,
"Daddy."
And then Edith would chime in.
Oh.
Thank you very much.
Welcome back to the world-famous Hollywood Palladium, home of the first ever TV Land Awards. And right now, I'd like to speak for a moment about child stars and what district attorney hasn't. The two glamorous people handing out our coveted TV Land trophies, glamorous as they are, may be more familiar to you in their childhood disguises.
I don't want to play anymore.
Come on, Adam, throw it to me.
No.
That was a helpful Prince by Castle.
Two little witches on the cusp of adult evil, all grown up and casting a new spell. Here are our trophy bearers from Bewitched, Tabitha and her brother Adam, Aaron Murphy and David Mandel. Hi, guys. Thank you. Just don't throw any water on them, because what a world, what a world. They're witches. You can go now. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. You'll see them all night. Would you believe these next two spellbinders starred in the greatest and most successful comedy series of all time? Would you believe the greatest soap opera? Would you believe a very hot infomercial? Would you welcome Agent 99 and her 100% lunatic partner, Maxwell Spark, Barbara Feldon, and Don Adams?
Good evening. Welcome to Jurassic Park. I want to thank everyone in the world that I know and everyone in the world that I don't know for giving me this award.
Max.
I want to thank my dog, Sweetie, and her girlfriend, Butch.
Max.
What is it, 99? Don't tell me they're not giving me an award.
They're not giving you an award.
I asked you not to tell me that. Well, what are we here for?
We're here to present probably the most important award of the evening. It's your favorite second banana. And the ones that you picked out of the bunch are...
Favorite second banana. Barney Fife, The Andy Griffith Show.
Come on, right? Ha! Now I just force you. I push you. Huh? You want to let me out?
Huh?
You want to just let me out?
Is that all you're going to do?
Well, no, you did something wrong.
Ethel Mertz, I Love Lucy.
We got off of the bus in front of Richard Widmark's house because Lucy wanted to pick a grapefruit that was growing in his backyard. So she got up on the wall and she tried to get it and she fell over the other side, and then she told me that she couldn't get out. So she said for me to go around and wait in front and that she would go through the house and meet me out there, and I've been standing out there for an hour and she never did come out. And stop saying, madam, you've got the wrong number.
Tim Conway and Harvey Corman, The Carol Burnett Show.
What's the matter?
You slid down as many poles as I have, you'd be chafed, too.
Ed Norton, The Honeymooners.
Hey, Ralph, I dropped the match in the bed. Ralph, I dropped...
Not a match.
And the viewer's choice for favorite second banana is Don Knotts as Barney Fife.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll polish this sucker every night. Gee, thank you. Thank you, TV Land. It's wonderful. I also want to say a special thanks to Andy Griffith. You know, a second banana. A second banana is only as good as the top banana he's bananaing with. And Andy's one of the best. We had a great cast on that show, a lot of fun. And you know, we started the Andy Griffith Show in 1960. We were just hoping we'd still be around for a second season. And if I'm not mistaken, this is our 43rd season, so I'm going to stop worrying about that. Thank you.
Tonight's TV Land Awards is brought to you by Revlon. Still to come, Oscar winner Mira Sorvino.
I'm presenting an award to the cast of Star Trek.
As the first annual TV Land Awards continue. For exclusive award show footage, trivia, prizes, and more, visit TVLand.com.
It's a funny thing being a redhead. When I was a kid, I just wanted to be like everybody else. Now is one of the things that makes me, me.
Get your best color. Revlon High Dimension Hair Color. So precise it only takes 10 minutes to deliver rich, dimensional color where it's needed most, every time. With deep conditioners that gently protect, so your hair stays soft, shiny, beautiful.
And I like being me.
Revlon High Dimension Hair Color. 10 minutes to beautiful.
Revlon. Be unforgettable.
Wetting the bed? I'd really like to stop that. If one of my friends came over and I wet the bed, I would feel scared. They have helped because I don't wet the sheet anymore because of the good nights, so I don't have to change my sheet or my blanket. I just put on new ones and I go right back to sleep.
To the 1 in 9 kids who wet the bed, Good Nights disposable underpants protect yet look and feel like real underwear. Good Nights mean good mornings.
They helped me be more confident in myself.
Here we go, Bertie. Okay, here we go. I'm spinning around. Two, three, four. Okay, go. Let's go. Oh. Oh. Hey, wait.
Stop.
Other TV Land Awards were given tonight, thanks to all of you for voting online in the Viewer's Choice categories. The 2003 TV Land Awards are proud to honor the fans' favorite in the category of small screen to silver screen. This year's winner is John Travolta.
This is one of the most awesome awards I've ever received, and I'll tell you why. Because when I was on television,
I had a dream, and that dream was to bust the cliche that TV actors couldn't get into movies.
You're watching the 2003 TV Land Awards.
Cat TV again? Whiskas knows how to get your cat's attention. Whiskas Tender Bites, a meal finely diced into tender morsels, lightly coated in a mouth-watering gravy. They're the smaller bites with a big taste.
There, dinner and a movie.
Whiskas, what cats want.
Kohl's Kids Who Care recognizes kids who make a difference. Nominate someone at Kohl's or visit kohlscorporation.com. Kids ages 6 through 18 can receive up to $5,000 in scholarships. Nomination period ends March 15th. Visit a Kohl's store for more details.
Pets, same exact heartworm and flea medications delivered to your home, saving you time and money.
It costs less than buying from my veterinarian.
It only takes a phone call.
I saved a visit to my vet's office. I didn't have to leave home.
Pet Meds delivers my pet's medication right to my door.
It's cheaper and more convenient than buying from my vet. I save time and money.
1-800-PET-MEDS. We deliver savings and convenience on HeartGuard, Advantage, Frontline, and all other pet medications. Call to order now or order online. Where do you get your pet's flea, tick, and heartworm medications?
I have to get to the vet's office.
I saved a visit to my vet's office. I didn't have to leave home.
I just call 1-800-PET-MEDS, and my pet's medications are delivered right to my door.
1-800-PET-MEDS guarantees the lowest price on all your pet's medications. Order online or call now. You're watching the first annual TV Land Awards. Stay tuned.
Our next presenters spent a dozen years pretending they were brothers, which was easy for two of them who are actually really brothers in true life, but devastating for the other one who quit acting altogether and became a film composer. In fact, he did music for a Blake Edwards movie called Skin Deep. Please remain seated. Please welcome Fred McMurray's three sons, Barry Livingston, Stanley Livingston, and the maestro, Don Grady.
It's time for the Viewer's Choice Award for Favorite Dual Role Characters. This award is grounded in the theory that everybody has a twin who's yearning to join the Screen Actors Guild.
Some of us just have a brother, though.
Yeah, the award is also based on the theory that everybody loves to see an actor play his own twin.
Nobody more so than the actor.
Or his agent, if he can get two commissions.
And that if you do play twins, you will inevitably win an award. And you know what? Tonight, we prove the theory to be right.
Favorite dual role characters. Elizabeth Montgomery, Bewitched.
Is this trip necessary?
Yes,
and it's just a local stop on your way back to your freakout in Soho. Why are you bugging me?
I was having a perfectly groovy time in jail.
Barbara Eden, I Dream of Jeannie.
Poopsie, what is it this time?
Jeannie. Do you not recognize me? It is your sister, Jeannie!
Christopher Knight, the Brady Bunch.
Sorry.
Holy mackerel! You look just like me, and you look like me without glasses. Boy, are we gonna drive the teachers out of their skulls. Yeah.
David Hasselhoff, Knight Rider.
You know, it's people like you who give revolution a bad name.
This isn't a revolution. It's a personal conquest.
That's what I mean.
Wow. Well, I've got the, Uncle Charlie's TV dinner here, I guess. And the viewer's choice for the favorite dual role character is... It's upside down. It's Barbara Eden as Jeannie and her sister.
so much. My, this is exciting. I think of what I see on TV today, and I remember when the network wouldn't even let me show my navel.
Oh, really, darling? Are you still nattering on about your belly button? The other night, I watched NYPD Blue, and I saw Dennis Franz's entire rear end.
Jeannie, what are you doing here?
My dear, darling sister, the award is for a dual role. Did you really think I wouldn't show up? And besides, I need the exposure. The Olsen twins can't be stars forever.
Well, your name is not on this award.
Yeah, it's not on the residual checks either. And I've been meaning to talk to you about that.
Well, you really have a nerve, you know.
Poo, 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 poo. You want to take this outside, huh? Or maybe in the bottle? And we all know what a disaster that would be.
Game on!
Coming up, Halle Berry gives tribute to a groundbreaking actress. Plus, Paula Abdul.
I know how to wear the genie outfit very well.
And Diahann Carroll receives the surprise of a lifetime as the first annual TV Land Awards continues.
Tonight's TV Land Awards is brought to you in part by Orbitz.
Where in the world can you find the best deals on travel? Visit Orbitz.com. Only Orbitz has the most web fares from the world's leading airlines for the most low fares anywhere. And now save up to 75% on hotels with our exclusive Orbitz Savers. From great deals on airfares to hotels, no one lets you see the world and save like Orbitz. Visit Orbitz.com for travel made easy.
This is TV Land.
Da-da-da-dum, da-da! I'm gonna get in that job, it's the last thing I do.
Holy eggshells!
Yes, sir, happy days are here again.
TV Land, putting a fresh twist on classic television since 1996.
Thank goodness for TV Land.
Every weekend we host a festival of bad taste.
And irresistible TV we call the TV Land Kitchen.
Offering new perspectives on our rich television heritage.
See, somebody flagged us on the television.
You just ran to see who it was.
As E.T. takes an inside look at the Brady Bunch.
This week on TV Land Legends, the 60 Minutes interview.
TV Land, celebrating classic television. And coming soon to TV Land, more great shows.
Good idea. Oh, thank you, Master.
Yippee!
For the best of everything television, all day, every day, there's no place like TV Land.
You're bound to have a good time with Verizon Wireless and unlimited text messaging for only $2.99 monthly access. Plus, share unlimited night and weekend minutes on the America's Choice National Family Share Plan. So don't miss out on some surefire fun. Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you.
Mom, this chicken's the best.
My mouth said wow, but my head said how?
New One Step Seasonings. In less than 30 minutes, One Step turns three ingredients into something amazing. It's new from McCormick, the taste you trust.
A blotch. A rough spot. A few dry patches. They stand between you and a healthy, radiant skin tone. But now there's Vaseline Healthy Body Complexion, a new lotion with Vaseline moisturizers, alpha hydroxy, and multivitamins. It works while you moisturize to help make the bad spots disappear. For more radiant skin tone all over, stick with new Vaseline Healthy Body Complexion.
Brilliant performance. It's the Kiwi Express Sponge, the only sponge equipped with a unique liquid reservoir that always delivers a brilliant shine. The Kiwi Express Sponge, a brilliant shine every time.
When you can hear your wedding song eight different ways, when you can see sunny skies ahead, when you can pick tulips over roses and chicken instead of beef, when you can get a reminder of why you're marrying him, when you can do all this with a calling plan starting at $19.99 a month, that's M-Life from AT&T Wireless. Right now, get a free Motorola 120T phone after $50 mail-in rebate. Hurry in or call 1-888-MY-M-LIFE today.
ladies and gentlemen, Academy Award winner, Halle Berry.
So, last year's at the Oscars, you remember, I won one, right? Good, because the rest of what I have to say won't make sense otherwise. So last year at the Oscars, I thanked many women of color who had gone before me, who had opened the door. One of those ladies who was nominated for an Oscar for Best Actress for her performance in the 1974 movie Claudine also opened the door in television. She was the first black actress to star in a network series. The show, a warm-hearted comedy called Julia, was an enormous success. Regularly finishing in the Nielsen top 10. It entertained millions while helping to point the way America was going in the 1960s. It also guaranteed nationwide stardom for Diahann Carroll. She has been a star ever since, a symbol of grace, elegance, wit, and enduring style. Tonight, TV Land is honoring her with a special award for her breakthrough role. Let's take a look.
Frankly, you're not exactly what I expected.
No?
No, not from what I've read here.
Did you expect me to be older or younger?
I think that Diahann Carroll brought a wonderful realism to television in her portrayal of Julia. It was wonderful to see this woman portrayed with such great bearing and dignity, and to see an African-American person on television certainly was groundbreaking.
What's prejudice?
Let's say prejudice is when some people think that they are better than other people.
There's a lot of different dynamics to African-Americans, and she gave us a different choice. She brought a different class to TV. She just played a hard-working single parent, you know, widow. That was probably kind of revolutionary for that time.
Earl J. Wagadorn's got a color TV.
Earl J. Wagadorn has a daddy that has a job.
I don't want you to get a job.
I have to, son.
Diane's influence was definitely there. She understood what it means to a woman to be a single parent and to have a career too. And so it was infused with her understanding, and that was obvious.
You're the only man I've got.
Don't worry, Mama. We'll find you another.
She opened a lot of doors for me just by getting on that network, just doing television, winning a Golden Globe. I mean, she did it.
I believe you came here to beg me for a job.
I came here at your invitation to be interviewed for a position as a nurse. I don't beg for anything.
Great pleasure to introduce to you a woman I love from the bottom of my heart, Miss Diahann Carroll. Diahann, they've forgotten to bring me the award, so, oh, wait, here comes that cute little guy that we just saw, Mark Kopaj.
My son, look at this. Thirty-seven years later, that's how they look. I must thank Halle for taking the time to come tonight to make sure that this was a major presentation evening for me. It was a very long time ago that I received a phone call from a very nice gentleman at NBC whose name is Dave Tebbett. And he, Dave Tebbett, he said to me, you know, I don't think you understand what's going on around you, and there's something that is going to be very important. It's called television. And I think you better be a part of it. And I packed my bags. I left New York. I packed perhaps for 13 weeks, I thought. And I've been here since 1967. Thank God. It is a strange animal, television. I'm very proud to say to you that I've been a part of it. Ups and downs and kicks and, then recovering and then where have you been? And please let her come in so we can see what the hell she looks like at this age. Oh, yeah, they give you the really hard time. I'm very proud to have received this award tonight from TV Land. I thank them for remembering. I thank them for giving us this that I will show to my family, my two grandchildren. You've made me very happy tonight. Thank you.
Up next, Mama.
I'm not your mama.
An out-of-this-world tribute from Mira Sorvino. Mr. Cotter himself, Gabe Kaplan.
Welcome back. Your dreams were your ticket out.
Welcome back.
And Matthew Perry as the TV Land Awards continues.
Tonight's TV Land Awards is brought to you in part by Walgreens and McDonald's.
Does he catch it? Or doesn't he? Does it matter?
If only all businesses were like Walgreens Pharmacy, then all their stores would be connected. So you could go into any location, and they'd still know exactly what you wanted. Just like at Walgreens, where you can get your prescription from any of our pharmacies, anywhere in the country. Fortunately, there's at least one place that's designed around your needs. Walgreens. Why go anywhere else?
TV Land is the place for all your TV needs. From bread to bread, say to be.
I have diabetes too, but I found a way to make living with it a little easier. See, Medicare covers the cost of my diabetes testing and supplies, and I don't even use insulin. Here's what I did. I called Liberty Medical to see if I qualified, which I do, and now they take care of everything for me. Liberty handles all the details with Medicare and my insurance company. So I don't have to deal with any paperwork or upfront costs. It's a big help. Everything is delivered to my home. Liberty even springs for the shipping costs. And when it's time to reorder, they give me a call. That's one less thing for me to keep track of. They make it really simple. You should give Liberty a call.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare or Medicaid, call Liberty to find out if you qualify at 1-800-417-5140.
Mama keeps our house sparkling like sunshine. Mama keeps our house fresh like the springtime.
There's no clean like a bleach clean. So Mom uses Clorox Cleanup Spray for tough stains. Even sit-in stains other spray cleaners leave behind disappear before your eyes. And for a bleach clean in the bathroom, Mom uses Clorox Automatic Toilet Bowl Cleaner. With every flush, there's a rinse of bleach to kill germs. That's the magic of Clorox.
Mama's got the magic of
Take a wider smile everywhere you go with Dazzling White Toothpaste. So your smile is ready for anything. from Rembrandt.
Good doggy.
Like things light and fluffy?
Then you're gonna love the light and fluffy chocolate of the Three Musketeers bar.
The fluffier the better.
Hell yeah.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you a message of importance from the leader of the free world. Or she thinks she is, Mama.
Well, isn't this an impressive bunch of ne'er-do-wells? The Hollywood people. I'm seeing faces out here that are pulled tighter than my pantyhose. You know, I heard they wouldn't even let Angelina Jolie in. She had to leave one of her lips out in the car. Oh, knock it off. You're all here, and you're all alive, and you're all out of jail, and I'll bet nobody is more surprised than you are. So, you know, I gave a lot of you up for dead a long time ago, because that's what you've done to me. You know, people think that a woman my age doesn't watch television, and you're, why the hell should I, for heaven's sakes? It's nothing but filth and forensics. That's why I watch TV Land. Sure, I know it's not brain surgery, but you can watch all of that on another channel. You can see liposuction on Lifetime. You can see Botox on Discovery. You can see a sex change on the Animal Planet. And you don't even have to click around that much if you watch the Michael Jackson special. And then there's Joe Millionaire. Let's all tune in to see which bimbo was so clueless that she actually thought that sleazewad was a catch. Lord. And what about Fear Factor? Why are we going to tune in to watch somebody eat a bowl full of red slop until they puke? Hell, I see that every Thanksgiving. You can tune in to see the news. I think they're running a special on 101 things you can do with all that leftover duct tape. You got your Meet the Folks. You got Somebody Marry My Mom. And then there's that other one where there's a mole running around. And then you got Ozzy Osbourne, who doesn't have the brain cells of a mole, and he's making $1 million a minute. What is the matter with you people? You call this entertainment? I'm telling you, we need to get back to the basics. The more important things. Family. Yeah. And it doesn't need to be a traditional family. It doesn't have to be a mom and pop sort of fandango. It can be like my family, a benevolent dictatorship. So the viewers of TV Land have chosen their favorite non-traditional family, and in fact, they found a huge bunch. Y'all gonna roll the clip, or am I gonna have to come out to the truck and kick some butt?
The quintessential non-traditional classic TV family. The Drummonds.
You're the greatest, Mr. D.
Arnold, you said it wrong.
I did? Oh, I did. You're the greatest, Dad.
No. I second that, Dad.
The Monsters.
We're going to let bygones be bygones and resume our life as an ordinary, everyday, normal American family. I think Spot's hungry. You may give him something from the table.
The Partridge Family.
If anyone had told me 4 months ago that I'd be driving an old school bus filled with my five children and a large dog through Hollywood, I'd have thought they were crazy. If they told me why we'd be here, I'd have been sure of it.
The Golden Girls.
Oh, darn, I forgot something.
Go in your pajamas.
Oh, it's not that. I forgot to say my prayers.
Oh, Rose, God wouldn't mind if you skipped a night. He's very busy these days. Most of his free time is spent talking to Pat Robertson.
And the viewer's choice for the quintessential non-traditional classic TV family is the Golden Girls.
accepting for the Golden Girls is Bea Arthur.
I want to make sure that I understand the award correctly. What is it? Quintessential, non-traditional, classic TV family. It's a lot of intricate wording for a show about four broads trying not to kill each other. But no, I think the wonderful message of the Golden Girls is that life doesn't stop when AARP starts. And a change of life is not just what you're left with after you've spent everything else. Nevertheless, you know, I really would have preferred getting the newcomer award. Oh, but hey, there's always next year. Thank you.
With Penny and Cindy, like the old days. I'm sorry. While I'm at it, for TV Land Awards, inside information, and a chance to win cool stuff, go online now to TVLand.com. Now, our next award goes to the landmark series that introduced us to creatures with huge heads, furry bodies, and cranky dispositions. That's right, it's I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. No. It's Star Trek. And to present it, that's what I'm talking. This young lady is an Oscar winner and a gigantic Star Trek fan. Mira Sorvino.
I think I should just say, just starting off, that I am so excited to be here talking to you guys about Star Trek tonight, because I have to preface it by saying that I did attend two conventions as a teenager, and I own a phaser. Live long and prosper. These were probably not the words that the network executive said to Gene Roddenberry when he ordered the first episode of Star Trek, but that is certainly what has happened to this cult success that no one believed would fly. It boldly went into the record books. Initially, it was just a science fiction series, an adventure in space, but it became a permanent fixture in the American imagination, loved by highbrows and lowbrows and strange creatures with no brows. For me and my dad, it was a special hour in the day when I was a kid, where we would sit together and watch and dream. And it presented us a world of limitless possibility, where new frontiers were open, new ways of living, thinking, a less warlike attitude was prevailing, and we could find out who human beings were by putting them against the backdrop of a pinhole velvet curtain of space. It became a political, philosophical, and spiritual journey for millions of people that has been going on for more than 35 years. Star Trek is a genuine cultural phenomenon, and here's why.
Space, a final frontier.
When Gene Roddenberry created Star Trek in 1966, his mission was clear: to go where no science fiction series had gone before. The series broke new ground with a multi-ethnic cast, TV's first interracial kiss, and the first time a TV star was forced to slap himself in the face repeatedly. But in 1969, after only 3 years in orbit, the mission was prematurely aborted. But television was not the final frontier for the series. 3 decades after its cancellation, Star Trek has proven to be the most enduring show in the history of television, with 4 spin-off series, 9 feature films, and dozens of new characters.
Since 1972, Star Trek conventions have kept the series alive in the hearts of fans all over the world. Star Trek merchandise, both old and new, is still in high demand. And Star Trek has even given the English language new words and phrases.
Kirk to Enterprise. Beam us up, Scotty.
Star Trek has moved beyond the realm of just television. It's part of our very culture. And so Gene Roddenberry's unique vision will most certainly live long and prosper.
The TV Land Award for Pop Culture goes to Star Trek. Ladies and gentlemen, William Shatner, Leonard Nimoy, James Doohan, and Nichelle Nichols.
I think of Star Trek in glowing terms, not only the benefits it gave me in life, but also the challenge it has thrown out to the world, that life can be better, that a future does exist, that man can refine himself to channel his animal instincts into finer spiritual resolves. These are the things that Star Trek dramatized. These are the things that Star Trek believes in. So, on behalf of all those who are here and those who are not here, we accept this award in their name.
I'm very honored to receive this tonight. Thank you.
Thank you all very much. Thank you for Walter Koenig and George Takei, and particularly for DeForest Kelly. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you very much.
Tonight's TV Land Awards presented by Chevy Trucks. When we return, Davy Jones.
Hey, hey, we're the monkeys, and people say we monkey around.
And Ray Charles performs a classic TV theme favorite as the first annual TV Land Awards continues.
I hate it when he does that.
Sorry about the dust.
Come on, guys, let's go.
The powerful new Chevy Trailblazer EXT. Room for seven. Room for everything.
Ah, I left the bagels in the jet.
Chevy Trailblazer, like a rock.
I don't even know you anymore, Bradley.
My name's Gary. I hate you, Dad.
Nice job, Andy. I'm not really his father. That was a dramatization. But families in turmoil are real. With so many TV networks, we now spend more time channel surfing than bonding with loved ones. Thank goodness for TV Land, featuring a wide variety of the best shows of all time, so there's no need to surf. TV Land for TV satisfaction. Well done, Kenny.
Andy.
Whatever.
Tune into TV Land for Sanford and Son, starring Red Fox as that irascible Cuban dictator Fidel Castro. Sanford and Son, starring Red Fox as the irrepressible impressionist Peter Claude Monet. Sanford and Son, starring everyone's favorite cantankerous junk man, Whistler's mother. Watch Sanford and Son, starring Red Fox as Fred, whoever, every night at 9 on TV Land.
I'm gonna give you the big half of mine. Here you go, honey.
Enjoy.
Sharing feeds the soul. Bring a friend and try Denny's new hoagie melts, the hearty Philly melt smothered in melted Swiss cheese, or the delicious chicken melt covered with tangy cheddar. Try Denny's hoagie melts. And remember, sharing is good. Denny's, a good place to sit and eat.
These are the final days of the great shopping spree at JCPenney. Hurry in for 30% savings store-wide, plus extra savings on sale prices and clearance items. It's every girl's idea of fun. It's all inside. JCPenney.
Tell me what you see here.
Bacon! Bacon! Mm-hmm. Bacon! Mm-hmm. Chewy, yummy, smoky bacon!
No, it's Bacon Strips brand.
Dogs don't know it's not bacon.
It's bacon!
Huh? Everyone gets colds. Not everyone gets the same symptoms. Sometimes it's the hacking cough of a deep chest cold, or the pounding of an acute head cold, or the chills and fever of the flu. So Comtrex created customized cold care. Five formulas that target different cold symptoms. Nothing works better, nothing works harder. Nothing gives you more individual relief than Comtrex customized cold care. It helps your symptoms go away so you get on with your day.
Folks here appreciate things that last a good long time.
Like Scott Tissue.
Every roll has 1,000 sheets.
Hit it!
So it lasts and lasts!
Woo!
Take this for a spin.
And it's soft, just like you, dear.
Now that's soft.
Fill her up.
I'll get it.
Try this on your bumper.
Sweet.
See you later.
See you later.
Scott Tissue, common sense on a roll.
Welcome back to our celebration of classic television. Speaking of which, I have a new series, 8 Simple Rules for Dating My Teenage Daughter. No, please, no. I didn't mean to, that's embarrassing. I'm sorry, I find that sort of thing so cheap. And the only reason I bring it up is because I'm the host and I can. No, I'm sorry. What's going on? I bring that up because what else have you got to do on a Tuesday night, ABC, 8 o'clock, 7 Central? Sorry, regrettable lapse. I bring it up because I actually do get to play the father of teenagers, and I get to witness scenes like this.
You really come to the prom?
Well, there is one little problem.
What?
Well, I don't have a date. Do you know a girl that would like to go with me?
Do I?
Well, how about the flip side?
As you know, it's Dad and Mom who have to deal with the aftermath. Here from the Brady Bunch is the original Marsha, and her prom date, this year's winner of favorite guest performance by a musician on a TV show, Maureen McCormick and Davy Jones.
Too high, I can't see. Oh, I think we'd better hurry up because I have to have you home before 10, okay?
Okay. This...
Sorry.
This category is hotly contested. It's the viewer's choice for superhero. Not just superhero, but superest superhero.
Here are the nominees as interpreted by some of their youngest fans.
Superest superhero. The $6 million man. Wonder Woman. Superman. The Incredible Hulk. The Bionic Woman.
And the viewer's choice for superest superhero is Lee Majors as the $6 million man.
Thank you very much. There was a time when I could have just bounded up here. 40 years ago, in about 1963, I did my first role in a motion picture. I played Joan Crawford's husband. And in my little town in southeastern Kentucky, when it came to the local theater, everybody lined up from all the hills around. Little did they know that Joan Crawford chopped my head off with an axe, and I was killed before the opening credits came on. And the movie house later burned down and was never rebuilt. I'd like to thank the viewers out in TV land for their votes and for their support throughout my career. And I'd like to thank TV Land for the award. And one last thing is I'd like to everybody to remember to say a prayer for our superheroes, the men and women of our armed forces. God bless.
We have a wonderful musical guest to present to you, and this lovely, talented presenter. Well, she caused a tremendous flurry in country music. There's nobody bigger. And on Broadway, Nanny, Get Your Gun, and on TV. And oddly enough, in the Catskills, when she was accidentally booked into a Passover service as Rabbi McIntyre, here is the star of the sitcom Rabbi, I mean Reba. Reba McIntyre!
Celebrating classic TV shows. Now, you all know a classic TV show needs a classic TV show theme. You heard some of them earlier in the evening, but this particular one is a classic for a couple of reasons. First, the artist you're about to hear already had a big hit with the song years before the writer, Linda Bloodworth Thomason, dreamed up her show about a bunch of good old gals trying to make it as decorators in Atlanta, Georgia. Second, the man who sings it is not just a classic, but an American treasure. And I can't stop loving him enough. Ladies and gentlemen, Ray Charles.
Is brought to you by Revlon. When we return, Paula Abdul presents an award to a future classic on the first annual TV Land Awards.
What is unforgettable beauty? It's part confidence,
sense of humor,
style, and of course, beautiful skin. I leave the beautiful skin part to Revlon.
Revlon's age-defying all-day lifting foundation instantly leaves skin smoother while concealing imperfections, and its soy protein formula reduces lines by 30% in 2 weeks.
Be yourself. Be unforgettable.
Discover the value.
Coral calcium, only $7.50.
Discover the selection.
Glucosamine chondroitin, only $7.35.
Discover the quality.
Natural vitamin E, only $2.95.
Discover the convenience.
Natural vitamin C, only $1.15.
Discover the best way to buy the finest quality vitamins, minerals, and herbs right from home at incredible 70% savings.
CoQ10, only $4.80.
Discover Puritan's Pride, America's number one shop-at-home vitamin catalog.
Saw Palmetto, only $2.90.
Over 4 million people nationwide trust the Puritan's Pride catalog for all their vitamin needs.
Noni juice, only $8.95.
Call now.
Call now.
Call now for your free 70% off Puritan's Pride catalog and discover the smart way to buy vitamins.
Ester C, only $4.65.
All Puritan's Pride products have a 100% one-year money-back guarantee.
What are you waiting for?
Call now for your free Puritan's Pride catalog and receive a coupon for $5 off your first order. Call 1-800-427-1771.
You're watching the first annual TV Land Awards. Stay tuned.
TV Land, Sunday night.
Everybody got an Emmy but me.
I'd like to die on stage, for real.
I didn't want to do the show at first. I can't explain why.
My wife says that my tombstone's going to read, "Here lies Howard Cunningham, who used to be Tom Bosley."
Tonight at 10, it's TV Land Legends, the 60 Minutes Interviews, Mel Brooks. At 10:30, it's E.T. and TV Land, Three's Company. Sunday night on TV Land. It's television about television.
I love this, but I don't let them know. Oh yeah, show me the love. Being soft definitely has its advantages. And disadvantages. Whoa, big guy, easy on the merchandise. You're definitely not my cup of tea. I know.
Only Cottonelle toilet paper with thick, cushy ripples is Cottonelle soft.
Ha, can't even tell the difference. Fetch anyone?
Cottonelle toilet paper, looking out for the family.
I don't know what to do, Doc. I keep losing home loans to DieTech.com.
I see.
Customers apply online or by phone 24/7. They never come to the bank anymore. Even my mom got a loan from DieTech.
Very interesting.
Looking for a faster, easier way to get a mortgage? Call or log on to DieTech.com for today's low fixed rate.
So what do you think, Doc?
I think you just lost another loan to DieTech.
DieTech.com, 1-800-71-FIXED.
Here we go. Here we go, Bertie.
Come on, Pally.
Okay. Okay, here we go. Spin the trap. Yay! 1, 2,
come on,
3,
Kelly!
4. Okay, go. Let's go.
No.
Hey, oh, wait.
Stop.
Please welcome a person with plenty of platinum, American Idol's own Paula Abdul.
What makes a classic TV show?
There's a simple formula.
You find a group of people you'd like to be with, put them in situations that test their likability to the extreme, and watch them get through it. When it's over, you must be just interested in enough in how they did it to keep coming back for more. You know, it's a lot like a dysfunctional family that miraculously manages to function at least once a week. There's a new family on TV this year that shows all the markings of a future classic. Interestingly enough, their lives are set in a classic period for television and pop music, the early 60s. And the show marries our nostalgia for that more innocent time with a contemporary understanding of family dynamics. And that is why TV Land has chosen American Dreams as its future classic.
What are you doing on Saturday?
Oh, nothing. Just hanging out with my good friends, the Ronettes and the Beach Boys, on American Bandstand.
What?
I love American Dreams. And what I fell in love with about the show, even before I fell in love with the characters, is the music. American Bandstand really shaped the teenage lives of kids in the U.S. And I think you see that point on American Dreams.
The fact that it takes place in the 60s makes my generation, or the younger generation, aware of what went on in that time. In terms of music, as well as political issues, family.
American Dreams is a future classic simply because it has all of the elements. Great cast, great writing, incredible production, and great music.
I am so thrilled to present this award to the cast of American Dreams, along with executive producers Jonathan Prince and my dear friend Dick Clark.
I'm very, very proud to be a part of the production team of American Dreams. Every time I look at one of the finished episodes, my whole life flashes before my eyes. But like every collaborative effort, you have to have a visionary and a leader. And our leader is my fearless friend and partner and executive producer, Jonathan Prince.
I love TV. I grew up watching it. I love Bewitched, and I Dream of Jeannie, and I learned about sex watching Love American Style, and I swore when I had a kid, I would say, like, I'm not gonna let him watch TV, and then I think, why? You can make a great living doing it, and it's fun, and God, it's so much better than law school. I wanna thank our cast and crew, mostly the people behind you. This is an amazing ensemble. They are not future anything. They are currently the best ensemble I watch on television every week, so I wanna thank them. So, thank you.
Still to come, Ted Danson, Doris Roberts, and heart-to-heart Stephanie Powers when the first annual TV Land Awards continues.
Tonight's TV Land Awards is brought to you in part by Orbitz.
Where in the world can you find the best deals on travel? Visit Orbitz.com. Only Orbitz has the most web fares from the world's leading airlines for the most low fares anywhere. And now, save up to 75% on hotels with our exclusive Orbit Savers. From great deals on airfares to hotels, no one lets you see the world and save like Orbitz. Visit Orbitz.com for travel made easy.
If you've ever felt marooned
or just lost at sea,
hate your job,
got beat by dogs,
and there's nothing on TV, don't despair, we're on the line. We got all you want.
TV Land.
Love almonds? Grab a new Snickers almond. Milk chocolate, nougat, caramel, and you guessed it, almonds. Hungry? Grab a new Snickers almond.
We're having Chef Boyardee.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Cheesy burger party.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Take your burger, top the cheese, turn it into constantly so fun. For Chef Boyardee.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Okay, Evan Mitt, time to get another roast out of the...
Look, it's Arby's new Italian beef and provolone.
The oven goodness of beef, roasted right in the store so it's juicy, not greasy, then marinated in Italian seasonings on a soft baguette.
Conta! Okay, I'll stop.
Try Arby's new Italian beef and provolone.
What are you eating today?
You've got your bedroom set, your coffee table, your armoise, as it were, and you've got the one thing you should be treating them with, Scott's Liquid Gold. Liquid Gold is a cleaner and conditioner. It goes way beyond dusting. It has organic oils that work deep below the wood surface. Hey, if you want to use a dusting product that's made of up to 70% water, by all means. But if you want something that works deep below wood surface, do yourself a favor. Try Scott's Liquid Gold. Good for your wood for over 80 years.
Air should smell fresh and clean, but inside, germs can cause tough odors in the air. That's why the makers of Lysol created NutriAir, an air treatment that helps eliminate odors in the air caused by germs. NutriAir, treat your air well.
For itchy patches of dry winter skin, moisturizers can't always cut it. Buy Cortisone 10 Plus. Among these, only Cortisone 10 Plus has 10 moisturizers, plus the power of Cortisone 10 to stop itch and help heal. Try Cortisone 10 Plus.
Please welcome the TV Land Classic TV Teacher of the Year and the world's most glamorous detective. Welcome back, Cotters, Gabe Kaplan, and heart-to-heart Stephanie Powers.
Stephanie and I are here to present the Crossover Award.
Now, Gabe, that could mean a lot of things.
I guess it could, but when I first heard about it, I thought there was something mystical involved.
Well, actually, Gabe, this award is for that rare occasion when the living cast of one show crosses over to another show and colonizes it for a week. At least we thought it was rare, but the TV Land viewers managed to come up with four favorite examples, and here they are.
Most amazing cast crossover. Laverne and Shirley on Happy Days.
Oh, what a charmer, what a wit. I'm not a package.
What are you doing?
Laverne, what are you doing?
Taking his temperature.
The Love Boat on Charlie's Angels.
Nice little boat you got here.
We like it.
I think they call it a ship.
Oh, well, even better.
It's sea talk. You get used to it.
Well, listen, as long as it doesn't have any holes in it, I think we're going to have a wonderful time.
Murphy Brown on Seinfeld.
Hi, I'm Murphy Brown. You must be my new secretary.
Oh, good morning, Miss Brown.
And who are?
I'm Stephen Snell.
Snell. Well, hello, Mr. Snell.
Stephen.
HR Puffin Stuff on Chips.
I am really sorry, officers, but my PR man scheduled me for a photo session. I apologize for the inconvenience, but...
Hey, come on, John, don't you know who this is?
I know he cut off two cars because his view was obstructed, all right?
No, man, this is Puffin Stuff. Don't you ever... I forgot. He doesn't have a TV set.
What? No TV? And you're gonna write me a ticket?
Hey, okay, I'm not gonna write you a citation.
Choice for the most amazing cast crossover is
The Love Boat on Charlie's Angels.
Accepting for Charlie's Angels is Cheryl Ladd, and for The Love Boat, Gavin McLeod and Bernie Capel.
Wow, it was so fun sailing with you. From all the other angelics, I just want to say that we're asking our underwear to do more for us these days, and we don't mind a bit. It's such a pleasure to be in the room with so many of the television stars that I grew up with and love so, so dearly. It's amazing to be with you all tonight, and I thank TV Land for giving us this opportunity to be together again. Thank you very much.
If I may, I would love to thank the TV viewers for allowing me to come into their homes for the last 45 years now. I would like to thank TV Land for letting my life flash before my eyes every day on television.
I just want to say thank you to Mary Tyler Moore, because if it wasn't for her, I don't think I'd be standing here tonight.
God bless you.
Please welcome three of America's favorite mothers. Leave It to Beaver's own Barbara Billingsley, Academy Award winner Shirley Jones, and Emmy winner Doris Roberts.
Thank you. Thank you so much. We're not here to present an award.
What are we here for? Is this The Bachelor 3?
In your dreams. We're here to announce a different kind of a partnership. The Academy of Television Arts and Sciences has undertaken a unique project. It's an oral history of TV designed to let future generations know what went before.
The Academy's filmmakers have conducted over 1,200 interviews, ranging from news anchors to variety performers to every kind of behind-the-scenes talent, in an effort to create a comprehensive picture of TV's origins.
The Academy's project is still underway, and TV Land is proud to support it. And now, here is a sneak preview of this classic piece of TV in the making.
I'm going to step off the land now. It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Ladies and gentlemen, rock and roll.
Television has reflected and shaped our culture for over 50 years. And behind every memorable moment, there's a story to be told.
President Kennedy died at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, some 38 minutes ago.
There was a moment when I had to announce that he was dead that I almost broke down.
I realized during the commercials that these people in the audience were asking better questions than I was.
And it saved us.
They created this awful wig, which I called my bubble dude. And I wore that for most of the first season.
My costume wasn't revealing. It was just an illusion.
Television's most unforgettable moments.
Helen Smith, come on down.
Welcome to Fantasy Island.
There are stories behind them all.
My mother, as long as I could remember, made at least one sweater every month. And so until she died, those zipper sweaters that I wear on the neighborhood were all made by my mother.
TV Land is proud to support the Archive of American Television, preserving our TV heritage for future generations.
They said, take your hat and throw it up in the air as though this is the happiest moment of your life. And I did.
Chevy Trucks, the official car of the TV Land Awards. Coming up, if you love the Dick Van Dyke Show, you won't want to miss our very special cast reunion as the first annual TV Land Awards continue.
I hate it when he does that.
Sorry about the dust.
Powerful new Chevy Trailblazer EXT. Room for seven. Room for everything.
Ah, I left the bagels in the jet.
Chevy Trailblazer, like a rock.
The home of modern TV classics welcomes Wings.
Feels kind of great, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Tune in for a special marathon of our newest show, starting Monday, March 31st, only on Nick at Night.
Be there or be stupid. Low, you can be both.
These are the final days of the great shopping spree at JCPenney. Hurry in for 30% savings store-wide, plus extra savings on sale prices and clearance items. It's every girl's idea of fun. It's all inside. JCPenney.
This is your son's science project. This is Bag in Season. Combine your favorite meat and veggies with the seasoning mix in the bag for a delicious meal, leaving you plenty of time to help your son with his science project. Bag in Season from McCormick, the taste you trust.
Afternoon, ladies.
Hi. You want to join us?
Me? Yeah, sure.
So what do you do?
I sell paper.
That is so interesting.
Really?
Yeah.
Where will you be when your diarrhea comes back? You should have taken Imodium the first time. It stops diarrhea, often in just one dose. Imodium AD.
I'm back.
Don't wait till it's too late.
What better place to test Scott Chew-sized towels than here? They need help.
Choose a size, let you use just what you need. A big towel for Charlie's chili.
Cool, wiping 101.
Or a little one for Polly's pesto.
A plus.
So big or small, Scott has just what your recipe calls for.
Mm-hmm. Scott, choose a size towels. Common sense on a roll.
You guys should just make sandwiches.
I was mighty flattered you invited me to come to Texas.
Well, I'm glad you came. You're gonna be the prettiest lady at the ball.
I'm afraid I'm a little good at dancing.
Oh, sure the music won't be too fast.
Oh, boy.
Texas sure isn't what I thought it would be.
Come see that Texas is more than you've heard. Stop online at TravelTex.com or call 1-800-8888-TEX and find out what to see, what to do, and where to stay in Texas. Have dinner by candlelight, not just campfire. See where we wrangle spaceships or drive more than cattle. Of course, you'll still likely see a stagecoach or two. Plan your Texas adventure at TravelTex.com or 1-800-8888-TEX right now and get your free 264-page Texas travel guide, accommodations guide, and Texas highway map.
Well, I don't know about you, but I could go for some sushi.
Texas, it's more than you think. It's like a whole other country.
And now, to present a special award, I'd like to introduce a man who spent quite a few years listening to people's troubles as a bar owner and is now set to spend quite a few years listening to people's troubles as a doctor. He's a very good listener, but that doesn't keep him out of his own trouble, which is usually the really funny part. The star of Cheers and now Becker, Mr. Ted Danson. Ted.
The first TV show I ever saw, ever, was the Dick Van Dyke Show. This is true, because we didn't have a TV when I was growing up in Arizona. I think my mother was afraid that it might make me shallow.
Can you believe that?
Anyway, so I bought my first TV when I was a freshman at Stanford University. I plugged it in, and on came the Dick Van Dyke Show. The show was in reruns, and I would get up at 5 minutes before 11 and watch it every morning. That's basically all I remember of Stanford. Dick's brand of physical humor had everything to do with me wanting to be an actor. So it was one of my great joys in life that I had the opportunity to work with him. Dick came to Becker and played my father on the show. He was as gracious and as elegant as you would want your hero to be. Thank you for that. The Dick Van Dyke Show has reached legendary status, not just in my household, but worldwide. Let's look at some of the reasons why.
I love that ottoman.
The Dick Van Dyke Show, starring Dick Van Dyke.
Dick Van Dyke Show is timeless and classic because the humor still holds up.
Hey, Richie, you'll love this.
Oh, no BB guns. Laura's against guns.
Okay, I'll take it. I'll use it on my boyfriend, Herman.
Casey gets fresh?
No, Casey doesn't.
Well, if you know Dick Van Dyke, you know that he is one of the most affable, likable, naturally funny men that's probably ever lived. That affability is what I think sets that show apart.
I can't picture you as a blonde, honey.
No, wait a minute. Yes, I can. You know who you look like?
Who?
Harpo Marx.
Mary Tyler Moore suddenly brought a new dimension to a sitcom housewife. She stood up for things. She had opinions. She would fall apart.
Oh, Rob, all these years we said we'd never lie to each other. And I lied to you.
What? Sex female? You're going to lie to me.
It's a show that told the truth in a stylized manner, and it was performed by people who were masters. They really epitomized what great ensemble acting can be. And it was just damn funny.
Honey, are you upset?
upset because I opened your mail?
Well, all I'm trying to say is that I would like the fun of opening my own mail and knowing what's in it first.
Here's another huge fan of Dick Van Dyke Show, the Emmy-nominated actor and star of the upcoming feature film, The Whole 10 Yards, Matthew Perry.
I can never get enough of hearing that theme song. First of all, I want to thank Ted Danson for being an incredible inspiration to me and also for stealing everything I was about to say about Dick Van Dyke. It's actually appropriate, though, because I've been accused my entire professional career of stealing from Mr. Dick Van Dyke. That, of course, is not true. My entire career I've stolen from Mary Tyler Moore. Dick and Mary took an unusual route to comedy. They were both trained dancers, so in addition to their acting chemistry, they brought a graceful physicality to their performing. Combine that with the shrewd vaudeville timing of Rosemarie and Maury Amsterdam and the nervous energy of Carl Reiner, and you get what made the Dick Van Dyke Show such an explosion of talent. But there's no easier way to kill a joke than trying to explain it, so we're going to stop now and just say to Dick, Mary, Carl, Rosemarie, and Larry, and everybody involved with the Dick Van Dyke Show, congratulations and thank you. You are a TV land legend. Now come on up here and be humble.
So great. I've loved this entire evening. It's like a family reunion. All the familiar faces from... I'm so proud to be a member of this generation. It's a great generation. I don't think it's going to happen again, really. And everybody looks real good. You know, it is so wonderful to look back on all those sweet experiences that we had together. But what is even better is knowing that we knew at the time what a break we had. We were in some kind of a creative Shangri-La where nobody ever made any mistakes, had nothing to do with the outside world. And it's all because of the genius of one man. We owe Carl Reiner so much, it's just incalculable. Did you notice that Mary got taller and I got shorter? Look how tall. I went like that.
But look at the heels. That's what it is.
Well, I could have brought heels.
Oh, yeah. Listen, I'm just so thrilled to get this award, and I'm sorry that Ed Asner and Valerie Harper and Cloris Leachman aren't here with me.
I was a young girl when this show started tonight. I have never in my entire life been so thrilled or so honored. First of all, with these people, you have no idea. You have no idea what goes on in television. We were a family. They were very, very close to me. We went through an awful lot. And the most important person in my life is missing tonight, Maury Amsterdam. And I love you all and I thank you. Very, very much. This is for you, Maury. This is for Maury Amsterdam.
My name's Richie, in case anybody didn't know. The person I'd like to thank most is right behind me, and that's Carl Reiner for giving a five-year-old kid a chance to get out of Burbank and do something different and be a part of a great history. and be here tonight. Thank you so much, Carl, and thank you, everybody.
Stood up, I thought this is the weirdest show I've ever been involved in. Really strange, wonderful show. It's an amalgam. It's the Twilight Zone show. Anyway, I want to thank Larry Jones and the TV Land people for knowing something, that the people up here who are going to get awards are not as young as they used to be, and these are the lightest awards that are ever. About a couple of months ago, everybody's asked me through the years, don't you think it would be a nice idea to do a revival, you know, of the Dick Van Dyke Show? Yes, right. And we've done a couple of retrospectives and biographies. And the other day, I sat down at my computer. Yes, I got a computer. And I started to tickle away. And I started to write. And if these guys will accept it, and Larry Jones, you have the first crack at it, otherwise we go to the networks. George Shapiro will handle it. But I'm going to write a half-hour situation comedy using only the live members of the cast. What they would be doing, the Petries and Sally Rogers and this fellow, what they would be doing today. And I've got about 4 pages done. If I get another... It used to be 46 pages. Now it's a 20-minute show you're doing for a half hour. So I can probably knock it off in 30 pages. Anyway, I'm doing that. Do I have a commitment for you that if it's good, you'll do it if the price is right? You guys. They didn't hear what I said. Okay. Anyway, I thank you so much for...
What? We'll do it for nothing.
For nothing. Remember that. For nothing. You made us. Anyway, this is, as I said before, you're all aware. And look at the lady with that hair. It is a weird evening. Look, stand up, would you please, so they know who I'm talking about. That's weird hair. No, Dick.
I always wanted to say that the words to the theme song we sang at the beginning of the show were written by the sweet and late Maury Amsterdam.
By the way, that was done in 4-part harmony, right?
Right.
Now, could you do it with your part, just to hear the lyrics clearly, right now?
I think I forgot. So you think that you got trouble? Well, trouble's a bubble. So tell old Mr. Trouble to get lost. Why not hold your head up high and stop crying, start trying, and don't forget to keep your fingers crossed. When you find the joy of living is loving and giving, you'll be there when the winning dice are tossed. A smile is just a frown that's turned upside down, so smile and that frown will get lost. And don't forget to keep your fingers crossed. And then I fall down.
You know, I just have to say, I always thought that if I behaved like Dick Van Dyke, I'd attract a girl as cool and as hot as Mary Tyler Moore, and I did. Amy, get them colored lights going. I'm coming home. But first, I'd like to close with a ballad that means a great deal to me. Now, stop. Hang on, one second. Hang on. Yeah. Ricky. I rehearsed a ballad, and I know we're late. Could you hold this person? Can we go back? You might have... I
Band Awards is brought to you in part by Walgreens and McDonald's.
Hey, look, don't cry. Shh, it's okay, look, Daddy's here. Buddy.
Sorry.
What? Okay. It's an elephant. Yeah.
Sometimes.
Daddy's funny.
We could all use a little help.
Daddy's funny.
If only all businesses were like Walgreens Pharmacy, then their customers could create and update their own online health profiles. Because at Walgreens, our pharmacists can see up-to-date information you've provided about all the medicines and nutritional supplements you're taking to make sure you don't combine two things that don't go together. Fortunately, there's at least one place that's designed around your needs. Walgreens. Why go anywhere else?
Whoever says children are a hassle doesn't have one of these. Richie, the amazing low-maintenance boy. Worthless trinkets.
Here's a paper clip.
Easily amused.
Funny joke.
Lightweight and portable, he stows away neatly in his own storage compartment and keeps out of sight for whole episodes at a time. Richie, the amazing low-maintenance boy.
He may not be the brightest boy, but he's the cutest.
On the Dick Van Dyke Show, every day on TV Land.